Hey everybody, it's Victor Santini and Shriek here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for the support as the like streak continues to roll on as we get closer and closer to the next like streak goal of 365 like streaks days. I mean, again, I know that it's a little bit boosted because of the double, the triples that we've been having over the years, but it's still pretty significant that we have still so much continued support on the channel here, and it really shows, and I really appreciate it. With everything that you guys and gals do in the comments and with the likes and the dislikes, all that stuff, all of that culminates in supporting the channel, and I could never repay you all. All I can do is just show you today's meme of the day, brought to you this time around by, I think this person has submitted before. It's a name that seems familiar. Amatolio sends in this gem of a meme. Title of the thread was very long, but definitely worth reading. Found another truly inspiring quote by Sinvicta, but on Huts, every item is sissy collab. Really, so much knowledge for only just one person. Glad he shares with us. It could be good, or it could be bad. Sinvicta 2020. You know, if only you could crawl inside of my head and figure out what's going on, you'd probably have not a great time. Or maybe you would, I don't know. Seed Day is going to be 6. Sierra Echo 2, Charlie Bravo Tango Quebec. We have a second item here thanks to us picking up Eden's Blessing yesterday when I thought it was Purity because, I mean, well, I thought it was Purity. Starting off with a Poop, a Strength card, and Mystery Sack. So, yeah, not a great start here. Good tiers rate, good movement speed, good shot speed. Not great damage, but, you know, we can make up for it with a decent tiers rate like we do have right now, combined with the fact that we've got a shot speed that is over 1, which is very good. One bomb gets us 11 cents down below here, and I think that's probably worthy, but I'm not going to use our bomb quite yet because it's the only one that we have. And oh my goodness, never mind. Just kidding. We're going to have ourselves Ipecac. So Ipecac is going to allow us to fire explosive tiers, which do massive amounts of damage, but Ipecac does represent a very clear and present threat to Isaac with your own self-inflicted damage, which is always going to be the problem with Ipecac. But if you're experienced enough or if you're just good enough, it's not usually a problem. You always have to be careful about angling the shots whenever you're talking about close range shots. I'm pretty good at the Ipecac layup shots. I do an adequate job at staying safe most of the time. Not always, most of the time. But obviously, Ipecac represents a huge amount of damage and a lot of just a lot of everything. I mean, Ipecac's great. You just got to be careful with it. Shout out to Spider Mod guy. I'll go ahead and take Spider Mod just because, out of respect. When we talk about respecting members of the Mosh Pit out there doing their jobs. Let me take that back. Doing their self-appointed jobs of like all the comment streaks. Spider Mod guy, definitely a shout out to them for you know, creating it. It's like side entertainment in the Mosh Pit. People really enjoy reading a lot of the more detailed explanations and threads that we have down in the comments. And you know, I just want to make sure that people understand and recognize that I see those. Even though I don't respond to 99% of the comments anymore these days, just because of the sheer amount that we have. And I'm only one person. I do still see them and read them, and I want to make sure that everyone knows that I acknowledge how important they are, and how much effort. I mean, a lot of people really put a lot of effort into their posts, and I appreciate it. Curse of Blind Floor 2. So this means that we are not going to be taking any items here that are not on the that are not in the Devil Deal or in the boss room. We don't need any bombs. I mean, we've got Ipecac. Also, speaking about our spacebar item real quick, the poop. If you really want to maximize your effectiveness, you should be using it on every cooldown. I'm not going to just because I'm just too lazy to use it. You know, but the poop can give you a nice amount of consumables, or at least at the bare minimum, a decent amount of money. But I personally I couldn't be bothered to use it on every cooldown. If I remember, sure. You also have to remember that we also have Ipecac, so we need to be careful about that detonating on top of us right as we you know, drop something down. The strength card, I'm still going to go with the strength card because if we get multiple two hard deals with the devil on this floor, I am going to pick it up. Although, at the same time, I don't know. Now that I think about it, because it's Curse of the Blind, I may not take the devil deal here. We just may not take any items. The reason being is because I do not want Mom's Knife with Ipecac, and I don't want Brimstone with Ipecac. I know. Shocking, I know. But the reason why I don't want Brimstone in particular is because they nerfed it a while ago, where if you have Ipecac and Brimstone, it used to just be a massive raw damage up, period, point blank, that's it. And it also, of course, made Brimstone poison. But they since nerfed it and made it to where Ipecac now always fires no matter what. And I think the same holds true for Mom's Knife. Maybe not Mom's Knife, but I don't want to get Brimstone here. I'd much rather just have the regular Ipecac shot. I know that seems crazy, but Ipecac is dangerous. It is very dangerous. So let's see what we get here. If it's a one-heart deal, then I'll take a one-heart deal, maybe. But even then, we don't want Cursed Eye. Yeah, I think I just think we skip. Just being honest. So we have a member of the Mosh Pit who is going out of their way to see what items I skip in a run, in any given run, or like what blind items that we could have had, you know, would it have been useful, would it have not been useful. It really is crazy how the Mosh Pit community and the Isaac community has really embraced the, you know, the series, like one another. No surprise that the Mosh Pit wouldn't embrace something, because obviously the Mosh Pit's great, but the Isaac community really has been, you know, welcoming for the most part, and for supporting the channel and the streak, and just, you know, and just everything in general. Wow, that was like a 3-second freeze right there. Got ourselves a Yave from Mystery Sack, and sure, why not? We've got Ipecac, we can get zany with it here. So we get the Crooked Penny, which is possibly going to pay out well, or possibly not. I am going to take the 9-volt here, and I am going to take that as well. Reason why I'm not using the Crooked Penny yet is because we can actually still gain benefit out of money. We don't need to not pick up stuff right now. Another Sun card. PhD. If you're wondering how come that dropped a card instead of a pill, it's because we have starter deck, and this could be good. Worth a shot. I wonder if that's set in stone. Let's find out. Is the 50-50 from... Is the 50-50 from the Crooked Penny set in stone? The sun. We don't have to do everything exactly the way that we did here. Now, what's funny about this is that we can keep doing this over and over again. I don't know. I'm going to do this a couple more times, so you have to bear with me. Does the 50-50 from Crooked Penny, is it seated? So far, all signs point to yes, or we could just be failing a roll 3 times in a row. Be very Sinvicta-like. I definitely know the feeling, especially after playing Blood Bowl. Game that I am probably never going to play again. I am very happy and confident with saying that. I like playing against the AI, but I don't know. You guys know me by now. You know, if I'm gonna lose, I want to make sure that like I caused myself to lose, or I was the maker of my own undoing, or if I just flat out get outplayed, that's fine. That's the reason why I love StarCraft. All right, we'll go one more time here. Oh, never mind. Just kidding. I didn't mean to walk out there, but whatever. It seems like the 50-50 rolls are indeed hard lined into the seed, or just the room itself. I was gonna go 5 times there just to test for test's sake. But because I walked out, it doesn't matter anymore. And we didn't even get PhD or the Sun card. But we know where the boss is because we've seen it like 3 times now. But yeah, losing a game just because of a dice roll, like losing not just a dice roll, but losing anything, any game, due to factors that are completely out of your control is just aggravating. And you know, every time I've tried to get Blood Bowl like going again, I'm like, yeah, you know, it's just like it's like Warhammer football, like, you know, yeah, the RNG sucks sometimes, but the RNG sucks for everybody, blah blah blah. I try to take that lighthearted approach to it every single time I make a new team in Blood Bowl, and every single time after like one game, I'm like, yeah, I hate this game. It's pretty bad. But there are people who love it, and I respect that. I'm not wired to appreciate RNG. You know, and a lot of experienced Blood Bowl players will tell you, it's like, well, there's just like in any football game, there's certain things you could have done earlier that you wouldn't have to have taken it down to a single dice roll, blah blah blah. It's like, okay, like I understand that and all, but it's hard to ignore the fact that like we just rolled like 2 double skulls in a row on a what should have been a routine tackle or a routine block or something like that. It gets hard to ignore that kind of stuff, and ultimately it just bums me out every time I played the game. I don't think I've ever felt happy after playing a game of Blood Bowl. That's a bad sign. That's a bad sign for any game, or really anything that you do. So I was playing in Coach Crendor's Crendorian Invitational League for 3 weeks. I made it 3 weeks, and after 3 weeks of the world's worst RNG that anyone's ever seen, and that's pretty much like what almost every opponent that I played against said. I gracefully bowed out of the league. I'm going to punch Crendor next time I see him. So we're going to go with Liberty Cap here just because we wanted to see a little bit of mapping, and we do see that right now. Still sticking with the Crooked Penny. Enough money here thanks to the Two of Diamonds and the small, and the not Small Rock, but Lucky Rock to buy stuff in the store. I'm still going to stick with Liberty Cap, though, just because I want to, again, get that mapping whenever we need it. With Ipecac, unless you have Explosion Immunity, the more shots you fire, the greater the chances that you're going to end up taking self-inflicted damage here. So you have to be... It's another incentive to keep Isaac very accurate whenever you're going for Ipecac shots. Like, rooms like this, you have to be very careful. But what the nice thing about Ipecac is that it has a fairly decent explosion radius, but the thing is, once you get used to arcing your shots and causing the shots to connect while they're in midair, that's the sweet spot of Ipecac. So you'll notice that my shots don't land, and they don't land on like a target or anything like that before detonating. They seemingly detonate overhead like that. And there's a hitbox above every enemy and above every rock in the game that you're able to land shots with Ipecac without actually physically having the shot touch the target. Worked out fairly well for us here. And that's why whenever we do have a good roll with the Crooked Penny, it pays for itself, essentially. I wouldn't mind having 2 gifts here, and apparently we are not going to. Yes, I will take the treasure map. I will take BFF here. No way I'm going to let those two go away, especially with us having Liberty Cap. Again, too good to let go. Get ourselves a free jumper cable here, and I'm fine with that. And we get a free charge baby as well. And I'm going to actually buy 2 charge babies. Tower card and a judgment card. Mom's coin purse. This is going to be all cards here because, again, we picked up starter deck. Yara rune, ace of diamonds. And that. Okay. have a 90% chance to deal with the devil. You would think that this is a slam dunk, but I don't know. If you were watching anyone else, you'd be like, oh yeah, 90% no problem. But since it's Invicta, you gotta admit, you're like, I'm not gonna take that bet. I mean, I wouldn't. I wouldn't take a bet on 90%. I failed a 98.75% in the game. On stream. It was incredible. So we do get an angel deal here. Cat of Nine Tails or Pentagram. I'm going to go Cat of Nine Tails just for the shot speed. And we get the soul, which I actually don't want or need. But I'll take it anyway. I guess we're getting our keys back here. And you see how dangerous it is whenever you have an enemy that approaches Isaac's positioning. Like, they try to get up close and personal. Bob's Rotten Head is not worth doubling. You're not going to be taking that because we didn't end up picking up PhD. We'll head on down. So the soul is going to take our... Essentially, it's going to take projectiles and deflect them. Kind of like an invisible like shield in a way. That will just simply turn shots away. Think of what like black... champions do against projectiles, like whenever they have that repulsion field. That's exactly what the soul is, and it is it's an adequate defense against some bosses, but there's sometimes like the problem that I have with the soul is that the repulsion field, the strength of it is a little bit let's say ambiguous at times. Sometimes it can be super great and you're doing tons of damage and you know, you're blocking damage and you don't have to worry about dodging because the soul is like jacked up to 11, and you just simply sit there and watch everything as they bend around you. That's when the soul is good. When the soul is not good is everything else, where basically it just lets it's like almost as if you don't even have it. So you're guaranteed to be there. Definitely do not want. Don't ever pick up Shielded Tears with Ipecac, unless you've got a death wish. Just don't do it. You're just asking for trouble or explosion immunity. We got another angel statue here. We'll take Swarm Protector. Remember, we do have BFF, so the damage on our orbitals are going to be much, much higher. And, I mean, we do have a Guppy item. Okay, so we're going to head on over to the item room. Excuse me. Bruh. Thank you. Okay. We should go into the store. Now, if you're wondering how come we have the compass effect right now without having the compass, it's because we have Liberty Cap. Liberty Cap is a trinket that will not rotate, but it can proc any one of the mushroom effects. But it can also give you a sort of temporary vision on the entire map. But if you have the treasure map, whenever Liberty Cap procs for the vision like that, the treasure map will actually remember what it's seen and then write those to your map itself. So it gives you basically the map compass effect. Not going to take the left hand here. We're not going to get Guppy. And even if we got Guppy, it's not going to matter that much. Because our tears rate is so bad. Yes, our flies will be doing tons of damage, don't get me wrong, but... And there's never a scenario where Guppy isn't good. But I'd say that we're good with what we got right now. We don't need anything else. It's been a while since I've gotten to do an actual Ipecac run. Mama Mega... I wouldn't mind getting Mama Maggie here. Okay. This is good because not only can we use it on this floor, we can use Mama Maggie on the next floor as well. And we can also put some money back in the donation machine. Shout out to Donation Guy. All right. Of course, apologies to Jam Jar Boy. I know that he's going to be trying to sleep right now, and he's he's not too happy with me. I mean, like, you know, he's got to know that, like, we got to use it, you know? Like, it's not like we're doing it deliberately just to make sure that Jam Jar Boy can't sleep or anything. It's just like, you know, we want a free room. We want a free hallway. We want a free floor. It's going to be Gish. Gish is not free. Again, you see the hitbox radius on Ipecac is pretty generous and not our favor. And we'll take growth hormones and head on down. And Curse the Blind had a feeling that was happening as soon as the game loaded. So, we are not going to be taking Boss Rush. We're not going to be taking item rooms. We're not even going to be going to the item store. We've already made our deposits, so I'm just going to just nope on out of here. Again, there's no reason for us to go into Boss Rush without us seeing exactly what we're taking. So, we don't really care here, to be honest. There we go. Yeah, let's go in the pool. Let's go in here first. Now, I do have a problem with taking Blind Angel items as well. But they're mostly okay. We got Eucharist, which gives us guaranteed angel deals for the rest of the run. Might as well see what's in there. Nothing we care about, and we'll just head on down. I get the angle here. I guess we can take the bottom one out first. And you see the shutdown, the huge, huge shutdown power that Ipecac has. And if you can get an item that synergizes well with Ipecac, or if you can just get the right stats for Ipecac, you're going to be in very good business for an entire run. I mean, it can take you quite literally from across the map at any time and be totally fine. You know, it's like your good old dependable car. No, may not be pretty, but it starts up, it gets you from point A to point B, and that's all you can really ask for from a car. Get a Joker card here. Doesn't really matter because we've got a Eucharist, so I'm just going to pass on it. Yeah, I guess we could take the Joker instead of the Moon card. Excuse me? Thank you. I've got some more Pokemon cards that people have sent in. Shout out to Alex from Texas. And Stone Gray Fox as well for the amazing cards that people have been sending me. And I'm still receiving cards pretty much every other day. It's really insane but awesome at the same time. I thought that Spider Mod, for some reason, was going to be able to take that one. Speedball. I don't think this is our third syringe. I think it's our second. I don't really want a third syringe. Or I don't really want Speedball. So I guess we'll take Blood Clot. Yeah. And we'll just head on down. All right. So as you see here, Liberty Cap already proc'd, meaning that we're going to have the full mapping and compass effect on this floor. We have an arcade here. That charge baby freezing everyone in here. It's talking about sun. That's truly been awesome seeing everyone go through and sharing their. I've had a lot of stories about people's Pokemon cards getting shared with me here, and it's just been really really neat to see how everything is progressing. With this crazy new, I mean, it's not crazy. Like it is crazy what's going on with Pokemon right now, the Pokemon trading card game and the vintage sets and everything, you know, big YouTubers taking boxes, blah, 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 blah. But it's not that surprising if you think about just what year this is. You know, it's a year that everyone has to kind of stay home and make their own entertainment. And it's been spurring a lot of people to just go through their old collections of cards or hobbies, you know, maybe discovering a long lost hobby that they really enjoyed, but then, you know, forgot about. And then the next thing they know, they find out that their old Pokemon cards are worth hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. It's truly exciting for people. Diamonds, no thank you. Pretty sure the secret room is right there. I mean, I guess I could have just checked. It's just sitting there staring like, Yeah, there we go. All right, didn't really matter. Again, our 100% deal with the devil chance is now a deal with the angel chance because we, if you notice that very, very bottom stat on the bottom left-hand side, it's a 100% that has like a, what looks like just a regular cross, not like an upside down one or anything. That is the cross. And that's from the Eucharist. Not entirely sure which one it was going after, but you know, it's just it's fun. It's a fun time with Nipecac run. You know, you do have to be careful, but if you can get enough HP to kind of share to you the misery of just you know, just getting, I don't know. Ipecac is just fun, and being able to share the practice of lobbing shots and, you know, and seeing how it's done is really cool. And there might be some people who've never even seen Ipecac before. It's not that, it's honestly not all that popular. Thought she was dead. Right, let's take a look at this angel deal here. We could try Sagian and Glyph of Balance. No, thank you. Well, head on Ace up. Of diamonds. Five more hours of sleep last night. Felt good to get a little bit of sleep anyway, but still need more. Anytime I have a really late night, like I'm burning the candle at both ends, and I'm just sitting here watching YouTube and watching my friends stream if they're on, it's just like, excuse me, thank you. I think the thing that I love most about YouTube is just the fact that you can look up anything that your mood is in and just get answers or get relief or whatever most of the time. And with Isaac and with gaming on the whole, again, doing crazy numbers, maybe not to the growth extent of Pokemon, the card game, but still, it's really neat to just be able to be like, you know what, I want to learn how to do this. I want to learn how to cook, you know, Gordon Ramsay's scrambled eggs or something like that. And I think that the reason why people have stuck around with the channel for so long is maybe not necessarily Isaac at all. I've been seeing that. Like, I've seen people who say, like, you know, we don't watch to. We just like enjoying, you know, listening to the music or listening to the commentary, or whatever, to help relax. You know, that's like one of the greatest compliments that you could ever give someone like me. And YouTube giving people that option to be like, you know, hey, I don't really like Isaac, but I like hearing the commentary, or I use it to help fall asleep, or maybe they really love Isaac and they just don't like my playstyle. They just need to consume more Isaac content. You know, you can do all that in a click of a button. I mean, you all know this because you're watching this on YouTube right now. At least I assume, anyway. There goes Isaac. All right, let's see if the air rune paid off. Get lots of chests here. Aggie's bow, Lil Loki, Gila duplex, the halo, less than three, Harlequin baby, chemical peel, monster Manuel. Didn't actually want to take Lil Loki, but here we are. Wow, those are some items right there, I tell you that. And we have a long way to go to Blue Baby. I really don't want to fight Mega Stan, though. Not the best, most exciting tier effects in the game, but as you see, it's very, very, very powerful. There you go on that. Grab a Soul Heart. Stay a while and grab a Soul Heart, hero. Thank you, Uncle Deckard. Look, I mean, we're not here to save anyone. We're here just to kick butt and take names, and I'm all out of taking names. Hurry up. Charge baby, just doing a number on greed right there. Excellent block by our orbitals as well. Thought I had enough real estate over there. Turns out I didn't. Papula duplex is what's giving us those sort of crescent-shaped tiers. And basically, it just makes our shots have like a slightly higher hitbox on our targets, but it's a largely forgettable tier effect with Ipecac. It's better for non-Ipecac runs, just because, like, you have kind of like pseudo-spectral tiers because they go over everything. Maggie's bow, of course, is just going to be a HP upgrade, but any HP that we pick up is going to heal us for double. And you all know Mongo Baby, the Halo, and Less Than Three, and Lil Loki. All three of which, not terribly incredible. I mean, the Halo can be okay because it is the only other, it is the only other, like, true all stats up in the game. There is another one, SMB Superfan, which gives you tiers. You know, and I believe that I think the Halo gives you shot speed as well. I don't remember. I have to go to Platinum God after this. Yeah, it's a funny game. So, anyway, thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this Ipecac run. It was a lot of fun. And, yeah, if you wanted to have a good seed to practice some Ipecacin for, then definitely check the seed out, because it was totally worth it. Again, you see here the generous hitboxes on the top of the enemy's head. There we go. So, yeah, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Another really fast run here. And we have Ipecac to thank for that. And I have you all to thank for doing what you're doing. Each and every one of you who are down there leaving comments and continuing your comment streaks. And even those of you taking part in the daily discussion thread, I really appreciate it. And I hope you had a great start to your Friday, everyone. Until next time, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Derplop, Seven Fangs, Fred Wick, Fellwood, I don't know. I think that's it. Cinder and James Shanahan. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then please go to my Patreon, which you can find at patreon.com/invicted. And that was actually not James. It was Yanez or Yanes or Hanez. James Shondart. Yanez Schoenhart. Hang on, I've got this one. We're doing it live. We're doing this one live. All right, here we go. I'm gonna make sure I get this one. This one's counting. Oh, it's not gonna let me. Well, Yanez Schoenhart, thank you very much. And this is the end of the video. Happy Friday, everyone. Thank you, patrons. You're beautiful.